daddy says that a real man can stand up for what he believes in. So Andy constantly finds himself wondering what to call himself now that he can no longer do so. Wakes up many nights in cold sweats because he can still feel the itch. Hands feverishly scratching his imagination underneath the sheets. You would think that after 18 years he'd be over here within the colonial sanctuary of his white house with his perfect picket fence, his wife's loving race just within arm's reach, and the son just down the hallway who wants nothing more than to be just like his daddy. You would think that here he can find some measure of peace, but for Andy, it will always be war. I mean, what good is the perfect white friends if all it does is remind you of military grave markers, memorializing the misinterpreted prayers of mothers begging for their sons to return in one piece? I don't think they meant resting in it in awe. He sees when looking at that white house the clouds, same ones he found himself looking up at moments after the mortar blast blindsided him at a quarter past. His wife's embrace holds him about the same way as that medic did. He can hear them whisper the same way, it'll be okay, knows that it won't. See, here at home, he's just Andy, husband, father, walking desert storm casualty that never received his tax, a 21-gun salute, but in his dreams, he can still be Private First Class Andrew Stone, patriotic as a missile, son of a war vet. He swims deep in REM sleep and remembers nights of his limbs steeped in sweat when he can still feel that itch. The fear of dying in desert heat hang heavy in the Iraqi air, making his skin feel like his trigger finger dying. The killer of Saddam can't tell who's sane, who's not, can't stop replaying that day in his head, trying to get from a doorway to a war-torn building wall 20 feet away without becoming a folded flag placed into the lap of his wife. His life replaced his country and what he was fighting for. And halfway there, Miss Brittany felt like he might endure, but that was right before that direct hit connected unexpectedly 3 inches away from where Andy's hope resurrected, left him lying there, defeated, literally not a leg to stand on, left him lying there, defeated, sent him back to his native land, 3/4 a man, trying to understand what it feels like to know there is no VA hospital fit to treat the supernatural torture of feeling an itch on an area where there is no skin to scratch. There will never be a prosthetic built that will be able to complete him. Andy will always be 2 feet away from the man he always wanted to be. Drives him crazy, can you blame him? He's hearing rumors of America needing 20,000 more soldiers. His son is 17, going on eligible, and wants to be nothing more than just like his daddy. And his father only wants to stand up, carry his son somewhere where Uncle Sam can't molest his future for his future, but he can't. Not here, not while in his wheelchair, not in the area from his knees to feet are still air. He feels scared because his daddy says that a real man can stand up for what he believes in. So Andy constantly finds himself wondering what to call himself now that he can no longer do so. Even though his wife calls him love, his son calls him hero, his father calls him man, he can't hear them because Andy